Here we have our familiar two-link robot in a configuration where Q2 is greater than 0. And overlaid on that is the robot with the same end effector position, but Q2 is now less than 0. These are the two possible solutions for this robot in order to achieve this particular endpoint pose. We might be interested in how the robot moves from one configuration to the other. And it's an interesting motion for the robot because the endpoint position is exactly the same, but the joint angles Q1 and Q2 need to follow some interesting trajectory to move from the first configuration to the second. Here's a more vivid example in three dimensions, and this shows a Puma 560 robot moving to grab a ball. And we can see that the robot is making that grasp in either the left-hand configuration or the right-handed configuration. And we might ask the question, how does the robot move from a left-handed configuration to a right-handed configuration? How can we compute the trajectory that allows that to happen? Once again, we're going to define a model for our Puma 560 robot, load that into the workspace. We have the robot object, so here the workspace variable P560. I'm going to define a pose that I'd like my robot to adopt. And that's given by this homogeneous transformation matrix here. I'm going to define a new workspace variable that represents the set of joint angles required by the robot to adopt this particular pose in a left-handed configuration. I use the ikind6s method, pass in the homogeneous transformation representing the desired pose, and the switch L to indicate the robot is to be in a left-handed configuration, and this is the required set of joint angles. I can do the same thing for a right-handed configuration. I'm going to create a new workspace variable called QR. So let's have a look at these particular robot configurations. I can plot the configuration QL, and it looks like this in stick figure representation. Have a look at that from a slightly different vantage point, and it looks like this for the right-handed configuration. Now, getting a little bit ahead of ourselves, what I'm going to do is to create a trajectory and show the robot moving from the configuration where all its joint angles are equal to 0 to the left-handed pose. It's going to do that in 50 time steps. Now, the result of the JTRAG function, and we'll talk more about this later in the lecture, is a matrix with 50 rows and 6 columns. Each row corresponds to a particular time step. Row 1 is the first point of the trajectory, row 50 is the last point of the trajectory. Each column represents a particular joint angle. Now, the robotic toolbox can easily deal with trajectories, so I plot, but instead of a particular joint angle, I plot a trajectory, and we see the robot now moving from the 0 angle configuration to a left-handed configuration. I can change this to move from the 0 angle configuration to the right-handed configuration, and once again I can plot that. We see the robot doing a quite convoluted looking motion. And finally, what I can do is show the robot moving from the left-handed configuration to the right-handed configuration. Now, this is an interesting motion because the robot starts and ends the trajectory with its end effector in exactly the same pose. But in between, the robot is going to go through some contortions in order to change from being a left-handed robot to a right-handed robot. So compute the trajectory, and then we're going to have a look at that. Interesting to see what the robot does here. You can see that the motion is quite complex. End effector ends up just where it started. Now, sometimes in a manufacturing scenario, a robot does actually need to change from being left-handed to being right-handed. Perhaps it needs to access objects at the extreme ends of its workspace and needs to change configuration. So these configuration change motions, there's no net overall motion of the robot, but while it's doing the configuration change, there can be some quite wild and exciting joint motions. You need to be a little bit careful when you command such a motion that the robot is not going to collide with anything in its workspace.